Hello? I want a real lawyer.
I am a real lawyer and you're my client.
Shut up, alright? Just shut up.
Go ahead. I'll look at the paperwork.
Hell with the paperwork, alright? You didn't even know my name.
Look, there was a mix-up, alright? Now what I need from you...
One second. You're going to sit there and talk about what you need. I think I'm in jail. Yeah? Let's talk about what I fucking need.
And what do you need?
I need a damn lawyer.
Which is why I'm here.
You think all this is a joke? Huh? I stuck in this shithole, you claiming to be a real lawyer. All this seems funny to you, right?
You have no idea who I am, do you?
Oh, I think I do. You're a worthless, dumb woman who doesn't even know who I am. That's who you are.
Well, you're Anurag Goyal. You're 19 years old. You were studying English from some shitty college in D.U., weren't you? You played football for a year.
I never played football, alright?
Anurag Goyal, you're charged with attempted murder and I know that. So save that shitty attitude of yours for someone else.
Attempted murder?
Well, that surprises you. Of all things, that's what surprises you.
Of course it does. See, I'm telling you I did nothing, alright? I went to a friend, I got a gun, and all I did was shoot him in the ass. Alright, but what's your attempted murder all about, huh?
Anurag, I need to ask you a very serious question right now. And I want you to be completely honest, because it's a matter of your life and death. Did you or did you not shoot Baba Rahim with the intention of killing him?
What again? I shot him with an intent to lodge a bullet into his lying bullshitting ass.
I don't believe that. Not for a minute, not for a second. Tell me what really happened. You went there to kill him, but at the last minute, you got scared, you aimed low. Is that
it? I aimed for his damn ass area and I hit it, alright? I wanted to shoot him in the fucking ass. Why don't you get it?
Why? Just tell me why.
It was something I could do, alright? It was the least I could do for my friend. He mentioned Baba Rahim. He goes around telling people lies, talking God, talking shit! And he thinks he can get away with anything. Get away with stealing people's money, get away with running people over, get away without even a shred of regret on his face, get away with fucking murders! And there is nobody to bring them to justice. You go to law, and you know what the law does? The law does fucking nothing. That's what the law does, that's what your law does. It's like you can do anything in the name of God, right? You know what that Baba Rahim says?
What?
He says he's the son of God. Son of God. I mean, how big do your fucking balls have to be to sit there with a straight face and claim a ship like that?
So you don't believe in God?
I will put it to you like this. How many sons of God do you know who travel in fucking chartered planes and have... I don't know, fucking acres of property in Gurgaon. He's a fraud. He's a fraud trying to make money out of people's faith. Why don't you get it? Son of God. Is the son of God supposed to be like this? Huh? I mean, I don't think so. God gave out special instructions of fucking people over before sending his brothers or sisters or sons down here to do a job. I mean, I don't understand that. People don't think like that. They think I'm a Chutiyar who have acted this way, taken matters into my hand and shot that bastard in the ass.
Right,
they say I'll be punished by God for my sins.
Where did you get a gun from?
I had this friend of mine who knew this guy. Who knew some other guy.
Who knew some other guy who knew how to get a gun?
Yeah.
Did it ever occur to you, Anurag, that we as individual people are responsible for the individual choices that we make? And regardless of how close we may think we are to someone, we have no control over their choices. And absolutely zero. Zero responsibility for the consequences that they face for it.
Zero.
That's right, zero.
Even when the victim is being denied his justice.
If somebody gets killed or abused or manipulated, there is nothing I can do about it.
Bullshit.
Nothing. And it doesn't matter if that person is a total stranger or my sister. It is not within my power to do anything to the perpetrator. It's in the hands of the law. The law, Anurag.
Law. Fuck the law, alright? Fuck the law! Law never helps, alright?
Somebody's father died due to post-surgery infection because the doctor forgot to clean up after stitching and he got away with it without a scratch on his reputation. A But that doesn't mean that he should get shot in his ass, does it? People die like this every
day. His father died, he deserves to get shot in the ass.
You've been ridiculous.
Oh, am I? You know my friend Jeff? Huh? He should be doing what you are doing right now. He should be my lawyer. Or a corporate guy making money or... I don't know, fucking making a career out of it. But where is he? Where is Jeff? He's dead. Okay? Jeff is dead. And why? Why is he dead? He's dead because a bunch of hoodlums killed him in the name of Baba Rahim. He bloody stood in the face of their phony religion and they killed him. And the guy denied his involvement. He denied that it was his men who killed him. He fucking got away with it. Son of God. You believe that guy's actually the son of God? Huh? A man who has dozens of pending rapes and murder cases against him. I have contact with all sorts of criminal outfits. Can't even speak for God, let alone be God. I mean, look me in the eye and tell me that a man like that should be allowed to do whatever he's doing right now.
Tell me
where is my mother's full police escort when she gets off from metro every night and has to walk back home alone? He killed Jay. Okay, Baba Rahim killed Jay. He killed my best fucking friend. I shot him in the ass. I had to. I wanted to. He fucking deserved it. Now I'm stuck in this jail and he's having a banana pudding in some plush hospital being taken care of like a fucking princess. After all this, is it ridiculous?
Everything that you're telling me, Anurag, everything, you know what it sounds like?
What?
It sounds like a real good motive to want to murder
somebody. I don't give a fuck about the motive, alright? Is it ridiculous? Guard!
That what Anurag was saying was not ridiculous. You know what was ridiculous was the fact that I, Meghna Jaiswal, regularly earned acquittals for hardened career criminals. Crack dealers, arsonists, rapists, murderers even. People with jaw-dropping criminal records. And then, 6 months later, I'd be asking for bail for the same guy, same offences, or worse. Anurag wasn't a criminal. He was just a boy. I believed I could get Anurag an acquittal without having to put him on that stand. I believed that the judge and the people, if led, wouldn't convict him despite all the evidence. You know, I could have easily asked for a lenient sentence in Anurag's case because I was a goddamn excellent lawyer. But I wouldn't plea for a lenient sentence in Anurag's case. You know why? Because right after our second meeting, when Anurag went back to his cell, he was assaulted by two other inmates, beaten too within an inch of his life. I wouldn't plea for a lenient sentence in Anurag's case because 3 days later, when the press trust reported that Baba Rahim had been rushed back to surgery, and that he had died on the operating table, Anurag was found unconscious in his cell the next morning with a fucking bedsheet tied around his neck. I wouldn't plead for a lenient sentence in Anurag's case because he spent the next 72 hours in a prison psych ward. And before being transferred to a special cell, I sat down with Anurag and I informed him that the prosecutor had filed for murder and that the charge carried a mandatory sentence of life without possibility. And Anurag, that stupid kid, he looked at me and said, without the possibility of what?
Thank you. morning, Logan. How are you?
How am I? I feel like I'm in Disneyland. What about you?
I'm good.
You're good. तो घोसड़ी के झाड़ू उठा ले। उधर
saying anything. You are the one who started this, all right? Don't put words in my mouth.
You know, you're believing like you're very little. What's that word in Hindi?
What's that word in English?
I don't remember that either.
I think you need a cigarette.
Did I ever tell you that I smoke? No. Those things kill you. So how come you're not a believer?
Look, Logan, talk to me about anything under the sun, but this is not a conversation I'm having with you right now.
You know, some of the greatest saints, they were also non-believers. Had a crisis of faith right up till the
end. I'm not having any crisis.
All right, well, what would you say if I tell you that God exists? Then what?
Great! We'll celebrate the proof of his existence. That's there.
Ron, just answer the question.
You
please stop.
We don't want to talk about this. Please shut the fuck up.
Okay. Well, let's just assume that God exists. Not only that, but he has a plan for you. That you are here right this very moment. Because he planned this to be the
you know,
first
Meghna, she likes me.
What?
My lawyer.
What about her?
I'm saying in my trial, I think my lawyer likes me.
Yeah, well, as long as the judge likes
no,
you.
No, no, she really likes me.
So what?
What so? Just saying she likes me. What's wrong with
her? Don't change the subject on
I'm
her,
just
right?
saying she likes me, alright? What's wrong with Meghna wanting to get with me?
Get with you?
Yeah.
Well, hey little Casanova, that is really special. And I'm happy for you. But let me tell you something right now. Either you're going nuts, you haven't played with your little Anurag for a long time.
You worry about your own little human, okay? All this crap, just because she really likes me.
What kind of a God-fearing woman would make goo-goo eyes with some criminal defendant like you?
You have to be a God-fearing woman? Why can't you just be a woman? Like, she's a woman and I'm a man.
So you think you're a man?
I'm just saying she likes me.
I bet she's fat.
She's not fat. Alright, just because you haven't got any woman that... Vidya Meghna, she's not fat. Alright? And what have you seen lately to be the judge of anything?
What have I seen? I see a fool sitting beside me, that's all I need to see.
Oh, so I'm a fool now?
Of course you are.
So you think you can beat this fool at a game of chess?
Do you even know how to play chess?
Do you?
We'll see.
Devavi?
You disrupted me. Don't ever change the subject on me, alright? And never interfere when I'm talking about God. Talking of girls, you see any girls lying around here?
I'm just saying.
Saying what? What I'm saying is, if you're horny, go into the corner, jerk off, or whatever. Just keep me out.
And I'm saying I don't want to have any conversation about God.
You need to get straight with the Lord, Anurag. You really do.
And you are straight with the Lord, huh, Lubin?
Of course I am.
You're not straight with Lord or anything, alright?
And you know that how?
Don't make me fucking hurt you, man, or I'll tell you how.
hurt me? Tell me, how can a little puppy like you hurt me?
You know what? You can call me all the fucking names in the world or down to be like I'm some school kid. That doesn't change the fact. Alright? People are right about you. Fucking slaughtered your wife, slaughtered your family. You're a fucking psychopath, you know that? Talking about God, not talking about kingdom of heaven. You know what? You can call your God 24 hours a day, but that doesn't mean anything.
Doesn't mean anything. So I talk shit.
Yes.
Huh. Well then tell me, what did you do to get in here anyway?
That's my fucking business and don't you ever enter that, alright?
I heard what you did. You killed a man.
I did not.
How was that?
You worry about your own shit, alright?
You killed him, didn't you?
I shot him in the ass.
And then?
What then? He felt like a little kid screaming. They grabbed me.
What happened to him?
They took him to the fucking hospital, alright?
And then?
They did a surgery on his ass. He was fine.
Fine?
I mean, I just shot him in the ass.
You just shot him in the ass. I suppose he must be feeling wonderful. If he didn't die because you shot him, how did he die then?
Doctors? Okay, medical malpractices? I don't know, alright? I mean, how difficult it is to take a bullet out of a man's ass. You take your scalpel, or whatever. You open the ass, whatever is not ass, take that shit out. What's the complication? Is it my fault that a drunk, irresponsible doctor can't tell a difference between a bullet and a man's ass?
So the doctor was drunk.
Probably.
How very convenient, right?
You know how these people are.
Well then tell me, Anurag, how exactly did the man die?
Like I said, complication.
What complication?
Heart attack, blood loss, kidney failure, I don't know, alright? This Baba Rahi, he used to call himself the son of God. I mean, is the son of God supposed to die like that? Because see, if I were God, and I sent my son down to do a job, and he came back like, yeah, dad, you know what, then they shot me in my ass and in my heart and everything. I'll slap the fucker upside his head. I'll say, hey, look kid, look yourself in the mirror. Now I have to send your sister down to do a man's job. Dumb fuck, he should be ashamed of himself. I mean, okay, in your religion too, they hung the Jesus from the cross, bang nails into his hand, bang nails into his feet.
You didn't shoot Jesus' ass, did you?
Of course not.
You shot a man.
Yeah, and I do it 1,000 times again, alright? That motherfucker deserved it.
Not the son of God, a man died.
But how is that my fault?
If you hadn't shot him, would he be dead now?
See, I'm telling you, but...
But what? Dead is dead, son. I hope you know that.
It's not my fault.
Meaning what?
Meaning it's not my goddamn fault. What the fuck?
That is just plain illogical. That's like you're telling me a blowjob doesn't count as having sex.
That's not
No man deserves to die.
Why? Because God said so?
Exactly.
One second. When exactly did God say that shit?
The Bible.
Fuck the Bible! Fuck the Bible, alright? Bible is not an autobiography. Chetan Bhagat can write better novels. Apostles didn't write any gospel in Jesus. That motherfucker never wrote a fucking word, not even a fucking postcard. That is a fact.
God.
There's no God, alright? Okay, so what, that person died? What's the big deal? He's just one man out of a billion. People die every day.
Well, they aren't murdered every day.
They have to run into you first to earn that distinction.
Or you.
I did something that had to be
then
done, okay?
Then accept it, Anurag. If you're man enough to do it, then be man enough to stand behind it. But you can't stand behind it, can you? Because you know what you did was wrong. You know it.
Do you know it's wrong to kill a man?
Of course I do.
Then why do you have lawyers fighting for your life?
Well, I'm going to do life imprisonment here anyway. I took responsibility and I pled guilty. Why do I have to get my neck in the noose then?
Then are you afraid of death? See, all you have to do is die. Then you'll be in heaven with God. So that's supposed to be the ultimate aim, Logan. Because see, if it's all true what you just said, that should be your aim, right? You just said it to my face with pride. You're straight with the God. What's the deal, Logan? There is no inner peace. You're crazy and you're angry.
I'm in prison.
Yeah, no shit, Sherlock. You killed your fucking wife, alright? Your ass is supposed to be here in prison. You say that I should be a man, huh? Why don't you be a man and go die like you're supposed to? You have got to insurance, women. What else do you need?
I don't have any more time to waste on somebody like
that. Yes, because you know when a person dies, there are only two things that happen. Either nothing happens, or something bad happens. There is no God. No white light.
On the first day of Anurag's trial, I was staring at this mountain of compelling evidence which pointed squarely against my case. The prosecutor had so much evidence, so many witnesses. He was so sure that he wouldn't lose. But then every piece of evidence that he introduced, I found a way to cast the slimmest shadow of doubt. And well, his witnesses, they were all Baba Rahim's devotees. I buried them, one after another. You know, in court, I constantly had to suppress my urge to smile. On November 18th, the prosecutor called me for a meeting. And I knew what was coming. He offered Anurag this. Plead to culpable homicide, he would recommend the minimum sentence. Anurag does 8 years, everybody wins. I turned him down, flat. I never consulted Anurag in the matter. Never even mentioned it to him. Because I knew I had a win. I so knew it. God's fucking plan!
See, Meghna, what I'm saying is...
Saying what? That it's God's plan that you should spend the rest of your life in prison. What kind of a plan is that, Anurag? It's the prosecutor's plan, that's whose plan it is. God, what is wrong with you?
I didn't say I believe that shit, Meghna.
Hey, how very skeptical of you, now?
Lubin was just trying to bet.
Lubin? You're on a first name basis now with that moron.
No, I see that moron every day. He's the only one I have up there. I don't have anybody to talk to.
Go, by all means, go ahead. Mingle with that deranged, psychotic killer.
See, he isn't really like that.
What? Anurag, do you have any idea? Any idea who Lubin George is?
I know. He killed his wife, right?
He killed his entire family. And in what way? Do you have any idea about the things that he's done? He's a fucking monster!
Alright, let's forget about it. Let's get back to the business, please.
No, maybe Lubin should be alive and that's what we should do.
Meghna,
wouldn't that just be great?
I didn't say anything. I was just dragging up a conversation.
Did Anurag, when you're sitting in the bar, drinking beer, eating chicken wings, then make conversation, alright?
So you're backing out now?
What the fuck? Are you backing out?
I'm not backing.
Putting my entire career on the line for you, Anurag. My livelihood, my reputation, everything. So you better be damn sure in that tiny brain of yours before we even think about putting you on that stand that's spawning perjury.
I believe in you, Meghna, and I'm going to thank you till my dying day. Believe me, please.
I could lose my license. They could toss me in the jail.
Well, I already am in the jail. I want to get out of here any way I can. Just please get me out of here, please.
Do you have a problem with lying?
I love to lie, just tell me what to say.
Tell me a lie.
About what?
Anything, lie right now.
I invented electricity.
Stop messing around, you fool.
I'm not messing around, I invented it.
Oh, so you know how electricity works.
Not exactly.
Then that's a dumb lie, tell me a smart one.
I tried to kill Baba Rahim that night.
What?
I mean, it's a lie. It's still a lie because I didn't try to kill him. But it's true because...
Because
I mean,
what?
It's true because it kind of makes sense that I would have wanted.
Forget it. I'm the prosecutor. You are you. Did you shoot Baba Rahim?
No.
Anurag, look me in the eye when you say it. Did you shoot him?
No.
Look at you, you're lying, you idiot!
What do you want me to do, Meghna? Say yes to that!
I want you to believe in what you're saying!
That isn't true, how can I do that?
Then make it true, goddammit! I don't care! Did you shoot him?
No.
Why can you say that?
I don't know.
Think about it, Anurag!
Because I'm not like that.
Why not?
It isn't in me.
Why not?
I'm not, you know.
No, I don't read minds. You're not what?
I'm like, guns scare me.
Oh wow, I thought guns scare everyone.
No, like holding one.
And why is that?
Because of something that happened.
Did you bring gun to the ashram that night?
No.
Would it kill you to say no?
No.
Good. Now why would it make sense to you that you wouldn't shoot Baba Rahim?
Because it's wrong.
What's wrong?
Shooting someone, it's wrong.
Fair enough. Did you shoot Baba Rahim?
No.
Anurag,
no,
you shot him, didn't
no,
you?
No,
you
no,
shot him.
No!
Did you ever think about hurting him?
No.
Say yes to that.
What? Why?
Because you only have to lie twice. When he'll ask you if you had a gun on you and when he'll ask you if you shot him. Everything else, tell the truth.
But it would make you look bad, won't it?
It will make you look truthful.
And that would feed him. And nobody can say shit about that.
Absolutely nobody can say anything about that, trust me.
Even though it's wrong.
You think what you did was wrong?
You mean technically?
Technically? Where the fuck was this technicality of yours last month when you didn't think that you did anything wrong?
I'm not saying I did anything wrong, but the truth is that I shot him, right? So technically...
What the fuck are you saying there?
I mean, what do you think about it?
It doesn't matter what I think!
But if I said it mattered to me?
What do you want to do? Stop the trial, plead guilty?
No,
is that what you want?
I just want to know what you think about it, please.
Judiciary, Anurag, they want to acquit you because it's right, not because it's wrong. And they don't think that you deserve life or anything close to it. And no one blames you for Baba Rahim's death except the Union of India. And what is that? It's an institution, a set of rules set to apply to each and every circumstance as if they're all the same.
But they're not the same.
They're not all the same. Anurag, your testimony will supply reasonable doubt. And that's all they want. And that's what I think. Make sense? Does that make sense to you?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah. I was just...
Just what?
I was just thinking.
About what?
About Jay.
What about him?
You know, we used to, Jay and I, we used to sneak out of our house on Sunday nights, jump the fence, you know, walk down the tracks, walk through the tunnels, looking for adventures, looking for discoveries, looking for shit. Play like we're some G.I. Joes, you know, picking up empty Pepsi cans or beer bottles as some fake walkie-talkies. And we would get so involved in our games and in our discoveries and in our stories. So many made-up stories. Looking for fortune, looking for ghosts, running for brats, talking about girls, talking about daydreams, talking in words that weren't even words, and it would always surprise us when we saw the lights. I mean, we could feel the train coming, but it were the lights. As the lights came closer, the rumble of the tracks, the sound of conductor's horn beating at us, we would get so excited that we would freeze. Second of freezing cold, hypnotized, waiting, holding hands, and waiting. And then bam! We would jump off the tracks, hug the wall, climb back up the platform and start running. Running back to our homes. One time, one particular time when we were holding hands and the lights came close. I don't know, something happened and we couldn't let go. Couldn't untangle ourselves from each other and we were into the lights. We saw radiation, we saw skeletons and I don't know, we were paralyzed in a way that I just can't explain. Till something blew us apart, just blew us apart. And we landed safe. We were crying. Jay ripped his brother's coat. Jay!
Speak up! Loben! Why are you being such a bitch? You know what you're acting like? You're acting like a fucking kid, you idiot.
Silent treatment.
Alright, fuck you too. I'm never going to talk to you again, never. Anyway, you're not interesting, you're boring. It's just a couple of more days, I'm going to leave here soon anyway. You're never going to see this place again, Loben, never! You know, whatever I like, I'm going to do the double of it. You like watching movies? Ah, love it! Movies! I'll go watch every movie out there. I'll go watch every fucking movie out there. I'll go to theaters and watch them. Come on, Loben, speak up! Loben! Loben!
Smells like rain.
What? Did you say something?
Said it smells like rain.
You going to court today or what?
They're going to hang me today.
What? Today?
Why? Were you planning to bake me a cake?
No, I was just saying that,
Saying what? Sorry. You know, people don't appreciate a human life. I'm trying to stay alive, make a contribution. And everybody has to be outraged. How dare he wants to live. And now that I'm going to die, you think that is going to make one bit of a difference? They're still going to be angry. Why does he get a bend? Why can't we torture him more? Why does he get a last wish?
Can't you appeal that shit, Loben?
I accept God's will.
That's exactly what I'm saying. What if it isn't God's will?
A lesser man might raise that question.
Come on, Loben, now is not the time, alright? I'm not lesser.
You're perfect. You're going to go home, smoke some cigarette, and everything is going to be fine, right?
That's right.
I didn't really kill a man. I don't really have to take any responsibility. God is going to work out a special plan for me.
Yes, why not? Sure.
Well, I guess when you're Anurag Goyal, it's just different, huh?
You're just fucking jealous that I'm getting out of
it. Jealous? Right? What do I have to be jealous for? Got your pretty woman doing your thinking for you. Meanwhile, I hear the sound of God. And he's telling me, you done good, Lubin. Now it's time to come home.
What have you done, Lubin? Good! Lubin, what good have you ever done to make God say some bullshit like that?
Well, why don't you ask him yourself if you are so interested?
I'm asking you.
You all love to get into the Lubin business, don't you? Makes you all feel safe and comfortable. Lubin killed his family, he's bad. We haven't killed anybody, we must be good. Every night, on this cement ground, knees bruised, ligament twitching and throbbing, neck aching, I prayed for you. I prayed to God, please God, please, please make Anurag who he is. But what he's acting like?
Yeah.
Is there something wrong with that?
You can do what you want though, right? That doesn't mean that
Doesn't mean what? Did it ever occur to you, Anurag? Ever? In all these days and nights that we've spent together, just once did it ever occur to you? Pray for me. That's what I thought.
Lubin?
Don't Lubin me now! Should have Lubin me back then!
Lubin, God doesn't hear me,
alright? God hears you, alright! And God, and you hear God. You don't like what he's saying, that is the truth.
You don't even know anything
about
God.
I know everything about God! It's people like you crying in the darkness, you don't know shit about God.
Yes, sure.
People wait on faith, like it's some kind of a gift. Well, it isn't like that. Faith is like a blade of grass, fighting its way through the concrete, trying to get itself a drink of water. That is faith.
Faith? Talking about faith? You fucking killed your own family, alright?
So what if I killed my own family?
What?
I said, so what if I killed my own family? They weren't much of a family to me anyway. Don't you always feel like every moment in our life is a certain build-up to a grand conclusion? A moment where we feel accomplished, finally at peace with ourselves. I thought falling in love and having a little happy family would be that moment for me. But I was wrong. And you know, I have these thoughts, these perversions. To do things which other people would conveniently call horrible. My marriage. I gave my wife everything I could. She was my life. But you know what she said one day? She came home and she said, "Honey, it's not working anymore. I don't love you. I think I'm in love with somebody else." As if I meant nothing. I was just a joke. My whole life had been just a joke. So I hit her. And I hit her again. Every breath of hers only reminded me of the utter sadness my whole life had been.
So I took the knife, and then I stabbed her. And I stabbed her again, and... Time to live the life that you've always wanted to. So I confessed to the murders and I accepted him as my savior.
You're talking about God? You're talking... Lumen, you're fucked in the head! Lumen, you're fucked in the head!
Well, if that's true, then what is your excuse, Anurag? How did it feel when you killed Baba Rahim? Did it feel good?
How are you going to enjoy killing a little kid and think God would ever want to shine any light on you?
God loves me, alright!
God loves you more than he loved that innocent boy.
God loves you more than that Baba Rahim. Answer me.
Maybe he does.
Maybe. That's not an answer. Get up to that witness stand tomorrow and tell the judge maybe I did that Baba Rahim. See what he tells you then.
I'm going home, Lumen. I'm going home. I don't care my fucking life, you lunatic.
The evil took you, Anurag. It took you so good that you didn't even know that you were gone.
I'm not gone. I'm not gone, alright? All this time I thought maybe you knew something about me, but no, fuck you!
I know you killed a man!
Yeah, I killed a man! One man!
One is better than two, Anurag.
It's different!
How?
I'm not like you.
You're exactly like me.
Fucking don't tell me who I am, alright? I know who I am. I'm good!
Not good, Anurag. You're not at all good, you know it.
I don't butcher the people I love and then say it felt good, right? I know how killing Baba Rahim feels. I know how it felt when I
know how that Baba Rahim feels. The man feels dead.
See, I'm not. I won't.
Won't what?
God!
No one can save you, Anurag.
God!
No one can save you from God.
God!
When I used to be a lawyer, I would wake up each morning, cranky as hell. And I would fantasize about sleeping in, calling in sick, having a meeting. I was always resentful about the demands of the job, the lack of life, the fact that it was hard. Once I got disbarred, I suddenly had all the time in the world. And I didn't want it. I didn't want it at all. Anurag's redirect had been masterfully constructed. And he was a master. He was wiping away tears, looking the judges right in the eye. And most of all, he looked and sounded completely sympathetic and believable. I was proud of him. I was prouder of myself. And why not? It was my defining moment. And I held on to it. A split second, too long. Anurag started sobbing and I was vaguely thinking, okay, get him off the stand. But before I could react, because the truth is, I was really getting off on how emotionally involved the judge and the people were getting over all this. And before I knew what was happening, Anurag started talking.
I'm sorry.
He told the judge not to blame me, that I was just trying to help him. I tried to cut him off. I said, no more questions. But Anurag, he kept on talking.
I'm sorry, God.
And talking.
God, I'm sorry.
Anurag will be eligible for parole in 2038.
I'm so sorry, God.